Welcome to Toyah and Robert, your agony aunts, deeply unqualified, but very willing and available to provide you with some useless answers to at least a few of your burning questions.
Robbie Riddle, you ask who is the creative manager out of the two of us and who makes the final decisions in these beautiful ruckus scenes that we send out every Sunday?
My wife.
It's true. I started to create these ideas because I was concerned Robert was getting too internal during lockdown. And he actually was starting to look quite grey and I was very, very worried about him. So it started off with dancing and that was a way of getting him to exercise. And then we got such huge responses around the world that it's evolved into other things that I've always done within my career, like design the record covers, the record kind of concept and the video concept. So it's kind of moved into that area. And I'm very happy to say that since we started doing this, Robert now goes to the gym 3 times a day and has a personal trainer.
3 times a week, actually.
Oh, sorry, 3 times a week. Yes. So next question. How do you know when you have written a good song?
Well, for me, firstly, when I play the piece of music, it sustains me through difficult times. I can think of 2 pieces that really kept me going. Secondly, if you present this to your bandmates, your chums in the group, perhaps Crimson Brothers, they strap on their instruments and begin to rock out. And thirdly, if it brings your audiences to their feet, even though it may take 30 or 40 years.
Yeah, I totally agree. Once the audience get to their feet, you know you've got a good song. Also, there's so many answers to this, but when you start a song and you can feel it in your solar plexus, you just get that kind of butterflies there, you know that something is connecting to you that is otherworldly. Brilliant Day off, I think it's off Ophelia's Shadow, isn't it?
Sunday All Over the
is
World.
Is it on Sunday All
I
Over the World?
So.
Brilliant Day came in 2 minutes and I don't know where it came from. And then there's other songs that I've written, like IER on Blue Meaning, that came from anger. And I knew it was a good song because it kind of dissipated my anger. And then with The Human, Small Town Psychopath, again was a judgment song. And it dissipated that pain. I could live with the experience, which was the reason for writing the song. And another one, Fragment Pool, helped me deal with the grief of my father. And I instantly knew they were great songs because they were the best therapy I had to write them. So I hope that helps. But I think above all, it's the audience reaction that tells you when you've written a great song. So the next question, Christina Thomas. What are your 2 favourite pop bands? That's a really difficult question.
Well, there's a challenge in pop. Can you say all that you possibly know about any particular subject truly in 2.5 minutes? So for me, are the Beatles a pop group?
Yeah.
Well, like Mozart, Rice wrote some nice tunes, so it would have to be the Beatles.
Yeah, but Mozart was thought of as a flibbertigib during his time. And I think the Beatles came in an era where no one understood them at the beginning other than the young generation. Look at them now. Every generation understands them. You can never underestimate pop. The people that get it right is an absolute cultural game changer. So the Beatles were on the zeitgeist, but I would also add the Rolling Stones, Devo, Depeche Mode, REM, The Cure. I've done a whole list.
May I?
Kraftwerk.
Oh, all right. Well, look, if I have a second pop band, it's got to be Blondie.
So next question, Elizabeth Evangelista. What are the unicorns' names?
Willip and Fripp Cox.
There you go. Augusto Rosa, what would be your top 3 books that changed your life?
The big shifters in the trajectory of my life have actually been examples of music. However, if we're going to books, one book did change the direction of my life. It was the end of Is There Life on Earth from J.G. Bennett, which was a transcript of an introduction to a Sherborne House course.
Stephen King on writing, great for creative people. Empowered empath, great for oversensitive people. Avoiding energy vampires, fabulous. And this is controversial because if you're not into the Christian faith, you will not like this book. But this is a life-changing book that everyone should at least study for a moment in time because it's about the journey of the soul. It's phenomenal. I know that's four books, but you've asked us such a hard question there. Andrew Chinisi. God, we're getting so many from Italy. Isn't that wonderful?
No, this is a gentleman in New York City, actually, Andrew Chinichi.
Just as good, just as good. Are all these people your friends?
I have an acquaintance with Andrew.
He chooses the questions. So if you really want to get your question heard, put it on my Facebook. Since you have so much experience as an actress, Toyah, have you ever encouraged Robert to give acting a try? I am telling you. Robert is a phenomenal actor. He should be in the remake of 10 Rillington Place. He has such a quality on camera that is both sinister and unfathomable. Would you agree? Okay, I think that says yes. Scott Steele, what can we do to remain calm during these days of overstimulation? Well, you can never, ever overstate meditation. What would you say?
I'd say discrimination. Firstly, is this, whatever it might be, is this necessary? Secondly, is it useful? Thirdly, do I want to do it? Necessity clearly comes first. And there is one example, you could switch things off, but not on a Sunday and not on a Saturday either.
I think what we've experienced and what DGM has experienced, that come Friday evening right through to Monday morning, the work has to stop because it's just too much for all of us. And if we're at home, everyone is sending and delegating work back to us. And I think we're all in the same kind of pool here. Another thing I wanted to suggest to you is the kind of escapism of sound and colour. So this is what we've been experimenting lately with within our films, is introducing colour in a powerful way. So sometimes if you're listening to your favourite music, but you're also close to your favourite colour, I think it can help you just focus on what's important, and that's you. So I hope that's helped you. Thank you so much, everyone, for your brilliant questions. Keep them coming to Toyah Official Facebook. Now, before we go, what is the magic chord?
Before the magic of this week, I would like to go back to a question from last week. Celebrating Christmas early. You know, I put these on Christmas. Christmas is coming soon. Yeah. I want Christmas immediately. So there.
It's going to come in a week. Yes. All our decorations are going up on the 1st of October. So, magic cord.
This week, instead of a magic cord, a magic fairy fingers. So, here's a magic fairy fingers for the week. Is in the C pentatonic or new standard tuning.
Brilliant. Thank you so much, everybody. Stay safe. Lots of love to you. See you tomorrow for Toyah and Robert's Sunday Lunch.
Be well.